Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 2217, Place People on a Bell Curve. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Today's question from Jimmy in my seminar in Huntsville, Alabama. Jimmy has data. He wants to summarize this data and then plot the results on a bell curve. All right. Now, one of my most popular videos out on YouTube is this one, number 1663, Create a Bell Curve in Excel. And given a mean and a standard deviation, I figured out the low, which is three times the standard deviation less than the mean, and the high, three times the standard deviation more than the mean, what the gap is, and a series of x values here. And to figure out the height, use this function NORM.DIST of the x value, the mean, the standard deviation, comma, false. And if you think about it, this video is really just using a series of fake x values here in order to get a nice looking curve. And we're going to use the same concept here, but instead of fake x values, we're actually going to have the people down here, and then the height will be this exact same formula. All right, so now Jimmy wanted to create a pivot table, so we'll insert a pivot table, put it here on this sheet, click OK, people down the left hand side, and then their average score. All right, so it starts out with sum of score. I'll double click there and change that to an average. Great. Now at the very bottom, I don't want a grand total, right click and remove the grand total. And we want to arrange these people high to low. And this is easy to do in a pivot table. Data, A to Z. Excellent. All right. Now we're going to do the exact same thing that we did back in podcast 1663, and that's calculate a mean and a standard deviation. So the mean is an average of these scores, and then equals standard deviation of those scores. All right, now that I know that, I'm able to create my y value. All right, so a couple things we're going to do here. First off, you can't create a pivot table, a scattered chart from a pivot table. So I'm going to copy all of this data over, and I'm just going to do that with equal D2. Notice I'm careful not to use the mouse or the arrow keys to point to those. And so we have our values here. These will become x values. The y value is going to become equal norm.dist. Here's the x value, comma. For the mean, it's that number. I'll press F4 to lock that down. For the standard deviation, it's this number. Again, press F4 to lock that down. And cumulative, false. And we'll double click to copy that down. All right. And then don't choose the labels, just choose the XY. And we will insert a scatter chart with lines. You can either choose the one with curved lines or little straight lines here. I'll go with curved lines like this. And we now have all of our people placed on a bell curve. All right, now some things, some formatting type things we're going to do here. First off, double click down here along the scale, and it looks like our lowest number is probably somewhere around 50. So I'll set a min of 50. And our largest number is 88, so I'll set a max of 90. All right, and now we have to label these points. If you're in Excel 2013 or newer, this is easy to do, but if you're in an older version of Excel, you're going to have to go back and use Rob Bovey's chart labeler add-in in order to have these point labels come from someplace that's not in the chart. All right, so we start out here. We're going to add data labels, and it adds numbers, and they look horrible. I'll come here and say that I want more options, label options, and I want to get the value from cells. All right, so the range of cells is right there. Click OK. Very important, I choose value from cells before I uncheck the y value. Right. Starts to look good. We'll get rid of this. Now the whole key here, because you have some people that are kind of overriding each other, is to try and make the chart as large as possible. We don't need a heading up there of y. Just delete that. And I still see like Kelly and Lou and Andy and Flo are almost in the same place. Jared and Ike. All right. So now this is going to be frustrating. These ones that overlap. But when we click on a label, we selected all the labels, and then click on a label again, and we select just a single label. All right, so now very carefully try and click on Andy, and just drag Andy up and to the left. looks like Jared and Ike are together. See, now that I'm in single label selection mode, it's easier. And then Kelly and Lou, drag them up like that. Maybe there's a better place so it's not overwriting Lou, or even like here. I can drag it on either side. All right, so what do we have? We have started with a bunch of data, created a pivot table, figured out the mean and standard deviation, which just allows us to figure out the height, the Y position for each of those scores, and the height of those hopefully will get people into a nice parabola-shaped bell curve like that. Now, I love this question from Jimmy. This question is not in this book, but it'll be in the next time I write this book. I'll have to add this. It's a cool request and a cool little trick. Bell curves are very popular in Excel, but check out my book, Mr. Excel Live, the 54 Greatest Excel Tips of All Time. All right, wrap up from this episode. Jimmy from Huntsville wants to arrange people on a bell curve. So we use a pivot table to figure out the average score, sort the pivot table so the scores are arranged high to low, get rid of the grand total at the bottom. These are essentially going to be the X values. And then off to the side, calculate the average and standard deviation of those scores, and use formulas to copy the data from the pivot table to a new range, because you can't have an XY chart that intersects with a pivot table. Calculate a Y value for each person with NORM.DIST of their X value, the mean, the standard deviation, comma false. Create an XY scatter chart with smooth lines. If you're in Excel 2010 or earlier, you're going to use Rob Bovey's chart label add-in. I'm going to have you Google that, because in case Rob changes the URL, I don't want the wrong URL here. In Excel 2013, add data labels from cells, specify the names, and then some adjustments. Change the scale along the bottom, change the min and max, and then move the labels that offset each other. To download the workbook from today's video, use the URL in the YouTube description. I want to thank Jimmy for this awesome question in Huntsville. I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.